شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أفضل الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. أما بعد، Alhamdulillah, through the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have been blessed to witness a large portion of the month of Ramadan. And inshallah, we hope and pray that Allah azza wa jal allows us to see through the entirety of this month and to reap the benefits, the blessings and the bounties that this blessed month of Ramadan has to provide. Inshallah, this reminder would be about something that we have to do in the month of Ramadan. We must break our fast and take suhoor so that we have energy to keep the fast the following day. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he instructs us in a hadith that hasten and break your fast. When it is the time for iftar, we should quickly ensure that when it is the time of iftar, we break our fast as soon as possible and we do so without any delay. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also says, لِلصَّاعِمِ فَرْحَتَانِ, that the fasting person has two joys. فَرْحَةٌ حِينَ يُفْطِرُ, the first is when he or she breaks the fast. And the second, وَفَرْحَةٌ حِينَ يَلْقَ رَبَّهُ, the second is when he or she meets their Lord. Why is there a sense of joy when we break our fast? The first reason is quite simple, because we have been deprived of food for numerous hours and we have not been eating for many hours. So when we see the beautiful food laid out on our table, there is this sense of excitement and joy because we are about to eat. But the second reason is far superior to the first. We feel this sense of excitement and joy and happiness as believers because we are fulfilling a commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are obeying a commandment that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon us. And this is what also gives us this sense of joy, this sense of excitement and happiness. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also instructs us to take suhoor. You know, when we live in the Western countries, perhaps from iftar to suhoor, the timing isn't too long. So many a time people might have a lot to eat for iftar and then not have anything for suhoor. But this is against the sunnah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us, indeed have suhoor, take suhoor and have suhoor, because there is indeed barakah in it. Why is there barakah in suhoor? Because first and foremost, the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam instructed us to have suhoor. Secondly, suhoor, it is in the last portion of the night. It is in the last third of a night. It is in a very auspicious time. So this is why we should have suhoor, because we will wake up at this time, we will eat something, and after having suhoor, perhaps we can use this time to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to pray tahajjud and do extra acts of worship. And another reason is that so we can refuel ourselves, so we have the strength to fast the following day and do acts of worship. And to do acts of worship and obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So from the sunnah we see that it is imperative that we hasten and break our fast and we ensure that we have a suhoor, even if it is something small. Whilst having iftar and suhoor, we should also be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for blessing us with all of these things, because there's many people around the world who do not have the luxuries that we do. We have many dishes laid out for us at the time of iftar and suhoor. So we should thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all He has provided for us. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving us the opportunity to witness the blessed month of Ramadan, and we pray and hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts all that we do in this month. Wa akhiru da'wana an alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
Shahru Ramadan alladhi